What's going on, guys? Alan B here. And I know I haven't made a video in a while, but I want to go ahead and make a video on the Nexus 6, and especially the price, because a lot of people are talking about the price of the Nexus 6, and I want to go ahead and give my opinions on it. So in case you guys don't know, the Nexus line of things is basically Google's own line of Android products, usually. There's also the Nexus Player, which I don't think is running really Android per se. But anyway, I could be wrong about that. I'm sorry. If you guys correct me in the comments, I'll learn. But anyway, basically, it's like the Nexus phone is Google's own phone. It runs stock Android as Google intended it. It gets, anytime a new version of Android officially comes out, it's the first devices to get it. And things like that. So, they also release tablets too. I'm going to be focusing on their brand new phone mainly. So, what's the big difference between the Nexus 6 and the Nexus 5, other than naming and the screen size? The big thing is the pricing. The Nexus 5 was $345, I think, if I'm not mistaken, $345, $349, around that price, off contract, completely off contract, so no contract at all. While the Nexus 6 is like other smartphones, like the Galaxy S5, iPhone, etc., where it is $645 off contract, which means they're going to have to put it on contract and make it affordable for everyone else. So a lot of people, because of this, think it's going to flop. There's already two big competitors in the smartphone sphere, Apple and Samsung. And yes, there are other phones like HTC and a few other phones. I forget the ones off the top of my head, like Motorola is another one I forgot to mention. But they don't really do nearly as well as Samsung and Apple. And do I think the Nexus line is ever going to do well as Apple and Samsung? Maybe years from now. Maybe. But right at the moment, no, I don't think so. But a lot of people are saying that this phone's going to flop because of the off-contract price. And that was the big thing about the Nexus 5. You get really good specs. Same with the OnePlus One. Really good specs, but a really good off-contract price. You don't have to pay enormous amounts of money for a phone or be stuck with the contract. But, like I said, I don't think it's going to flop nearly as well. Now, do I think it's going to do as well as the iPhone as is, or Galaxy S5? No, I do not. Yes, I do have an iPhone 5S. I'm not going to get the 6 because I'm on a contract. Yippee. Do I think it's going to do as well as the Nexus 5? I don't know, honestly. I don't think so, but I'm not 100% sure on that one. But I don't think it's going to flop. Why do I say that? Well, when you take a look at, say, the Nexus S and Nexus One, those are the original Nexus phones. Those phones were off contract as well, and they're around the same price as Nexus 6. They were pretty outrageous. But and they flopped too. They never sold well at all, frankly. It wasn't until the Nexus 4 and the Nexus 5 and even the Galaxy Nexus, where they had that very low price point. Sure, they didn't really market it well at all or anything like that, but especially the people in tech community, they bought the hell out of that phone. It got sold out for weeks on end. I remember the Nexus 5 when it got released. It was crazy. Same with the OnePlus One. It's on an invitation system, and it was really hard getting invitations for a while. Now, they have it on Amazon. But I don't think the Nexus 6 is going to be crazy. But I think Google learned from the original Nexus line. They learned what they need to do. If they're going to make a phone for $600 off contract, and then like probably $300-some or $200-some on contract, and that's minus, you know, AT&T Next or whatever, they need to really see how are they going to market this phone. That's the big thing about phones, if you guys realize. Samsung and Apple, they spend a shit ton of money on marketing. A shit ton of money. Otherwise, you know, especially if you look at Samsung, Galaxy S line wouldn't really be the get, you know, as huge it is now as if they didn't have the marketing to push that. I mean, if you look at the other Samsung products they don't market, you'll kind of see why. And, you know, you take a look at other manufacturers like Motorola. They sell decently. They don't sell nearly as well, though, because they don't really push the money for marketing. And I think that's why phones are so expensive, is because a lot of the money you get on a phone is marketing and packaging and whatnot. You probably, the hardware itself is probably about $400, as far as I think. I think they did price it at one point. Like, the new iPhone was about that price. So, I think in order for the Nexus line, mainly the Nexus 6, that's a big one, to sell really well, Google needs to market the hell out of this phone. How are they going to market the phone? Well, first off, I don't think they're really going to target Apple. I think their really primary focus is going to be other Android phones, like the Galaxy S line and the HTC One and things like that. And they're probably going to market a few things like this. Wireless charging. A lot of people in the tech community love wireless charging. And I think that's one of the biggest features, in my opinion, on the Nexus 5. Another huge feature, and I probably wouldn't care nearly as much as wireless charging now that I think about it, but things like stock Android. Completely stock Android. Smooth, buttery experience. TouchWiz, I absolutely cannot stand TouchWiz. Now, I haven't messed around with TouchWiz too much on the newer iterations, but I remember on my S3, it was god-awful. On my S1, even worse. I had a Samsung Galaxy Mesmerize, which is basically the Fascinate, but on US Cellular. TouchWiz was terrible on that phone. So, it's things like that, and updates. That's another thing about my, Galaxy S3. We didn't get Jelly Bean for a while. Same with KitKat. We just recently got KitKat not too long ago. And I think it was 4.4.2, not even the latest version. That's going to be the last update for the S3. Like I said, I'm on an iPhone now, so I'm used to getting the latest updates. But I think those are going to be the big points. There probably are a few points. Android L looks freaking amazing, in my opinion. I'm very excited about it. I'm more excited about it, definitely, than iOS 8. I wasn't really excited about iOS 8 much. But I think Android L is going to really help as well. And that stock experience is just going to be icing on the cake. So I think if Google really targets these things and really outmarkets their phone in some ways, they're probably going to outmarket it and overhype it. That's what I wanted to really say. They should hype this phone. They will sell decently. Like I said, I don't know if they're going to sell nearly as much as the Nexus 5. They probably have much more prepared in production. That's what I wanted to say. They probably have that kind of stuff already, planned and whatnot. But I think that if they don't market this phone, it will flop. I really do think, because you got the OnePlus One. You got the Moto Gs and the Moto Xs. Even for us techies, we don't need... Specs aren't everything. I know a lot of people still argue that point, but... I mean, even though I've owned a Moto G, it's still a great phone. It's a first gen, but still a great phone. And my sister has a Nexus 7, but I'm just kind of pointing out that the Nexus phone line is pretty solid. As is. And I think if Google really takes that and just markets the hell out of that, and their reviews are good and all the other fun stuff, I think it will sell decently. Like I said, probably not as well as Nexus 5. Definitely not as well as a Galaxy S line. Not nearly as well as an iPhone. I'm not saying it's going to sell nearly as well. But I think Google should know at this point they need to market the hell out of this phone. Otherwise, it's not going to sell as well. So who knows, maybe in the next coming months, if they do market this, you'll see, your average teenager with a Nexus. You'll see someone else with a Nexus. It's all about, at that point, it's all going to be about if they want the huge screen size. We'll see how that works out. Now, as for me wanting a Nexus, I do want the new Nexus, but I'm locked on a 2-year contract with US Cellular. And unlike AT&T, which I'm very upset about, you can't just take out the SIM and put in a new phone. It's like Verizon, you actually have to call them up and be like, hey, I won't get this phone switched out. It's stupid. Anyway, that's kind of my rant video. I know I'm kind of taking this a bit too long. It ended up being a lot better than I thought it would be. Like, it was my fifth or sixth take. Anyway, guys, what's your opinions on it? Please leave a comment down in the description. This has been Alan B. signing out. Peace.